too fast. Only wear no seatbelt. Bad look, got no. Upgrade, now she got. How about the range on? Who is the baby? He going in. Man, these old rappers getting boring. They be taking shots, I ignore them. Send them to the hood while I'm touring. Making plays out of town.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Just a short time ago, this the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football indeed in Chicago as their guys get set to do battle with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Time with Devontae Freeman. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well, usually you don't think of the cornerback coming in for a no gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
Yeah, and how about the range, too? Coming from the outside part of the play, moving his way into the inside and making that play happen. No gain for the offense, big play for the defense.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Now Ryan on second down. Looking deep for Julio. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A gain of 39 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. This is Freeman on first and 10. And past the 30, down to about the 27. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, Freeman. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting the tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play.
Hey, let's go.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the shotgun, Ryan. He drops it. dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. So a nice opening drive on the road. You get the 3 points. Part of you wonders if that might hurt them later not getting into the end zone.
Well, the good thing is, still first quarter, and they did come out of it with points. In a sense, they can look at it positively and say, hey, we set the pace in this one. I think that's how they'll go about it.
And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their 38.
Red, red, up! Red, red, up! 18.
Here's Trubisky to throw. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now it's Ryan. Throw left side complete. That's Hall. And he'll be out right at the 35. It's the first time that they've looked his way tonight, and he comes up with a first down on the play.
Get up!
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Leonard Floyd. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
21.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
On second down, Ryan. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. From midfield now, here's Ryan. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Well, we keep stats on everything, don't we? This is one that you don't want to have. That's his second drop right here in the first quarter.
Yeah, I was going to say, only in the first quarter. Certainly a ship that he wants to right quickly. The left side completion to Jones. Escaping the pressure right. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. He's going to let it, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot, And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
After the interception, here's Trubisky. Steps away. Hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Red, up. Single. Lock in. Gotta go.
A give to Howard. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who could do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. Throwing here, Trubisky. Eluding the pressure right. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
They run play action for Howard. Now Trubisky, flush to his right. Looks for White, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. On the counter, Devontae Freeman. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
There we go.
A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Flushed out right, and that'll be incomplete.
Appeared to me he was just trying to find an open receiver and got forced out to his right. Had to come off of a guy downfield trying to hit his back. Unable to connect. Should have been an easier throw moving to his right, though.
Yeah, much easier, obviously, for a right-handed quarterback who's going to his left. A little bit tougher.
Exactly.
And it's complete. Hooper. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And his throw is going to be incomplete. Kyle Fuller there defensively.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Ryan going to give it to Freeman. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down.
Hey, Tuesday. Gun. 21.
Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. That they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively. Obviously, 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Escaping the pressure. And got his man complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
Trubisky will throw. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now he'll let it go deep right side. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Lock in, lock in. Red, red, so.
Got it, double up.
Hey, gotta go, gotta go. Red, red, so. Red, red, so.
On third down, Trubisky. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. It was the linebacker Leonard Floyd on the stop.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The Falcons on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. And a timeout here. Timeout taken, whistles blown. Timeout taken by the receiving team. As they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Onto the field now come the Bears. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now Trubisky on first down. Looking deep for Gabriel. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Likely time for one final snap as they start out 1st and 10. After the interception, here's Ryan. Looking downfield for Jones. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Here's Coleman. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. So a couple of field goals, that's all we've been able to muster through two quarters of play. 6-0 is our count at the break. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They'll start things on first with Torrey Cohen, and he'll get this up to about the 40. Foyasade Aluakon made the tackle there from his safety position.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing, but with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Red, up!
On second down, Trubisky eluding the pressure right. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Well, this secondary has done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, there's a little extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the
It's caught inside the 25 and down to the 20. Trubisky finding White on a big play, and even 40 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. From the red zone now, here's Trubisky on first down. They'll leave it for Cohen, complete. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
18. Gotta go.
Play action. Now Trubisky. And that is incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. And that is going to be incomplete. The Bears tried it on fourth down, unable to convert. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. They'll try to get the ground game going with Freeman. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop it. Now a 3rd-down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll indeed go for it with Ryan. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
We always hear about guys wanting to make plays that quiet a crowd.
Yeah.
After that one.
Here in the third quarter, they were hoping to get the stop, get the football back. Not the case.
What a completion on a fourth down play.
Steps away to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Leonard Floyd in there to get him for his second sack of the night. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Here's Ryan to throw. He finds Coleman. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. Flush to his right. It's caught. Jones. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up the first down.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. A gain of 6 there on first. They should have got more out of that, though. He was wide open.
I love how emphatic you are with that call because that's exactly what I was thinking. Wide open in the flat. Give him a ball that he can use to get upfield with, not just catch and go over the sideline. They cost himself some yardage there.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up.
Pulling up in that new toy, the wrist on that boy, rock star like Pink Floyd, waving that rude boy, I'm waving at you boy, ran off on the two like true goy, imagine me do boy, you could never do what I do boy, still ducking that I did boy, just in Paris for a hit, boy. These ain't the same type of hits, boy. Can get, boy. You don't take these type of risks, boy. Cause this boy been throwing that like rich, boy. You miss, boy. Your numbers don't add up on the. That was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. Yeah. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of ringing off. I just happen to be alumni. Too legit, they still looking at me with one eye. The company I keep is not corporate enough. Child, you ain't often enough. A rapper turn can morph into us, but a turn rapper can morph into Puff. Dance contest for the I predict Al Roker. If you know, you know. I only ever looked up to you all get a bird. This Oprah. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop like a Walmart. We got the for the wrong sport. If you know, you know. If you know about the port, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know. You ever been hit with the water? Then had to wait, do you walk away? If you know, you know. When we all clicking like Golden State, and you and your team are the motorcade. If you know, you know. Been granting wishes like a genie to bad in two-piece bikinis. I've been hiding where you can see me. The skybox is right next to Riri's. Solely responsible for showing rappers how to stand on the front lines when started throwing bands. Where were you when Big brought the tigers in, cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin.